Quantum physics says energy is everywhere. Electrons, quarks, gluons have no internal structure or physical size, meaning that they're entirely illusionary, or to put it in another way, made up entirely of energy. Developed in 1922 and originating in Japan, Reiki uses this universal energy and helps you to tune it to you in one way. Let's go back to 10th standard biology. Diffusion, the movement of particles until an equal balance is created on both sides. That's exactly what Reiki does. The universal energy is tuned so that there is a balance created between that energy and the energy flowing through your body. A wonderful glowing radiance flowing through our body. Something that calms our mind and creates a feeling of security, well-being and peace is exactly what Reiki is. Having the chance to experience something like this was one of the main reasons I chose to dig deeper into this idea. If today you asked me to describe this, it wouldn't be possible for me to put it down in words, primarily because it's an experience like no other. But let me give you a shot. Imagine a load of stress upon you. That stress that parents, family, house, school, and you yourself put. And now imagine that stress just leaving your body and the path becoming clearer than before. That's exactly what Reiki does. An amazingly simple technique to learn, Reiki allows a student to tap into the undiscovered world of energy that flows in through their body. Right now, as I stand here to speak to you, the sarcastic laugh that some of you choked down is exactly the reason Reiki hasn't been given the recognition that it deserves. A technique that can calm your mind, soul, body, and can potentially heal another person isn't exactly one that receives a lot of recognition, primarily because of the uncertainty of it. Let's compare it to Western medicine. Any problem, when prescribed a medicine, should be solved. However, if these two people go and try to solve this problem through Reiki, they will require some amount of sessions, but the problem will be solved eventually. Let's take a simple example. A student breaks out into acne due to family problems, while another student breaks out into acne due to stress due to exams. When they compare this and go to Western medicine, they both will be prescribed the same medicine and the problem will be solved. However, if they try to approach this problem through Reiki, both of them might require different amount of sessions, but the problem of both will be solved. This is because though consciously aware, subconsciously they will be aware of the reason, and therefore, Reiki goes into that psychological aspect and solves the problem at its root. The only reason Western medicine will not accept this is because of the sheer uncertainty of it. In spite of this, 60% of America's best hospitals offer Reiki as a side program. While most of them consider Reiki to be somewhat beneficial, 67% of them actually consider Reiki to be one of the most beneficial techniques that they've ever employed. One of the most difficult rules for each of us to accept in our life is one of the most simplest. Our outer life is a reflection of our inner experiences. At some point in our life, the internal chaos or conflict is bound to translate into outer chaos or conflict, either in the form of fear, anger, stress, tears, which is usually translated upon another person. While most people find it easier to blame external circumstances, if you truly sit back and try to understand, you will begin to realize that what I'm saying is true. People start to make a mental image in their mind of how they want to perceive things. They start to create a mental structure and start living that dream instead of believing what the reality is. The problem? The real world is doing just fine. We're just not tuned to understand that. And this is where Reiki steps in. It not only tunes our body and gives us a great freedom, it allows us to experience a different level of peace each time until we're not only at peace with ourselves. When we're not only truly believing that we are fine, but we truly are perfectly fine. Reiki's studies speak louder than its words. From being one of the smallest healing techniques taught to a fortunate few, to being one of the top 5 complementary techniques, I feel Reiki has come a long way. But the biggest hindrance in its way is its sheer unawareness. But who knows? Maybe one day Reiki might be able to heal all those people Western medicine couldn't. The only certainty we have in life is that time is the biggest answer to all our questions. Thank you.